Hi students, success is not a single day's work, it's a day-to-day effort. I'm very happy to see you all in the 10th standard section. I'm Priya, I'm going to handle your ICT subject. I know you all are familiar with me, is it? So, like last year, you have to face the public exam, which is in software-based one. You all know that it is combined with the theory and practical section. Theory for 10 marks and practicals for 28 and 2 marks for worksheet. So, like this, in every year we are maintaining a worksheet and a practical notebook for ICT subject. So, past few years we have secured 98% and above A+ in IT subject. So, this year we are going to secure the 100% A+ in IT subject. Are you ready, students? Yes. So, let's start our session. The first chapter is about a design software. That is, the chapter's name is The World of Design. Can you getting any idea about what is the chapter about? Yes, it is about designing logos or posters like that. Yes. So first of all, we want to know about what is graphics software. So graphics editing softwares and graphical software, that is, you will be heard about that. What is that? Yes. So graphics software, which refers to a collection of or a group of programs which performs a particular operation which enable you to manipulate an image with the help of a system or a software. So for example, it is GIMP, Photoshop, you will be heard about this, is it? Coral Draw, Inkscape, like that. So first of all, you have to know about what is an image. What is an image? Image, it is a group of or a collection of pixels which represent a particular theme or a particular object. So in a digital or in a graphic software, the images which is divided into two sections, that is about vector and raster images. So before that, you will be working with the GIMP software, is it? Can we see, and we have the software Inkscape you have to study in this year. What will be the difference in that? Let's see the difference first. What is the difference of the GIMP and Inkscape software? The images, what is the difference in that particular images? Let's see. I have given it to you two screenshots. Screenshot for GIMP image window and here it is Inkscape. Can you see the difference of the two images? What is the difference you can see in there? Yes. In GIMP image editor, you can see I have zoomed the images. You can see the square boxes. That square boxes is known as pixels. So in GIMP image, while we are zooming the picture, it will lose its clarity. The pixels which is in the form of square boxes, it loses its colors. And in Inkscape, what is the difference you can see in that? You can see the answer. Yes, it will not lose its clarity while zooming, and the color will be present the same. Clear? And it's having this same shape. It is in the circle object I have zoomed. So it will not change its clarity. Yes. So the main difference of GIMP and Inkscape is GIMP, it is a raster image software, and here Inkscape, it is a vector image based software. So now you have got an idea about what is the raster vector images. The raster images, that is generally PNG format or JPG format. These are the raster images. While zooming, it loses its clarity. The raster images, it is generally known as big pack pictures. And we have studied the main raster image software, it is GIMP. For image editing, you know about that. We have exported the GIMP image in which type? JPG and JPEG. Is it? Right. But in vector images, that is the clarity of SVG picture. What is an SVG? It's known as scalable vector graphics. We can scale the picture according to the, some equations and some software techniques. It adjusting the clarity and its structure. So it can scale doubly. That is known as SVG. The vector image is in the form of SVG. And SVG pictures are the vector images and the example softwares you can see in that. Adobe Illustrator, Extra, and have LibreOffice shown in scale. So, and vector image software which we are studying in this chapter is Inkscape. So, this is the Inkscape window you can see in the software. While you are opening the window, you will get the contents like this. Can you see the difference of Inkscape window and GIMP window? Can you remember? Yes. The toolbox is already present in this window in Inkscape. But in Ubuntu, it is opening as a separate one. And here it is, you have a number of colors, that is color palette. You can choose the different variants of and color. And here the canvas is already present in this window. In GIMP, you have to create according to your needs. Clear? Yes. So you can thoroughly go through that particular window and you will get an idea. While doing the practical, you will be more familiar with these contents. So now let's go to the activity. The first activity: creating a logo for a coffee shop. So before, if you are creating the logo, you have to include a background picture and a particular logo and a text in that particular logo. Is it?
Yes.
So the first, you have to create a cup and saucer logo for that coffee shop with a steaming coffee. We have to create that such graphics in that. So let's enter into the activity. First, you have to brew a saucer. The steps which I am giving in this, and I am giving the practical, how you can do in that practical screen with this video. Go through that and let's see how it is working in that screen. After this, you can write this questions and its answers in your practical. We'll see you in the next class. Have a nice day, students. Now let's start our first activity. For that, first you have to be familiar with your Inkscape window. So go to Applications, Graphics, and in the group you can select Inkscape Vector Graphics Editor. By the name itself, you can see that it is a vector graphics, which gives a file with SVG format. And here you can see the difference of Inkscape from GIMP window. The toolbox, it is already present in the window. Is it? Can you see that? And here the color palette, that is the colors are arranged in the different style. Can you see that? Number of colors you can use in this image editing.
So these are the main difference we can see from Jimb and Inkscape. And the tools, which is, we have different selection tool in Jimb, but this is the one tool we can use in every different format for selection. And here it is, edit path by nodes. We have particular points in an object or in picture. We can use or edit that particular points. So these are the different tools we are using in the following activities. Okay, these are the different objects, the 3D objects and the rectangle symbol, circle and the different stars and polygons, text tool. So these are the main tool, and the gradient tool already we have studied in Jimb for mixing the colors. Here it is available. So these are the main tools which is available in Inkscape. Now let's go to the first activity, creating a cup and saucer for a coffee shop logo. Okay, so select the object circle and draw it in the canvas. If you need to increase the size of the canvas, here directly you can go on during the work. Directly adjust your canvas size while working. Go to document properties, select the size of your canvas. Now I am changing it to 500. I am just adjusting the width only, the height is okay. That is clear. I have drawn the circle. If you need any different type of fill color, means here you have option object, fill and stroke. Fill means the fill color, stroke it is outline color. Okay, outline of an object. Here if I need to change the color, means here also you can change the color. It is no fill, that means no color will be seen in this object. And if you need to display any color, means use the option flat color. If it is one any gradient type, means you can choose that gradients. These types will study in last. Okay, now these are the main options, the fill which have. And next is the stroke paint. Stroke paint means it is outline. Now it is not, we can't see any outline in this object. So activate that. Same as in stroke paint, so same as in fill color. So choose that and select any color for outline. If it is not present, means just increase the size of that outline. For that you have an option stroke style, increase the width of your stroke. Can you see that the difference in the screen? You are getting in a green colored outline. Okay, if you need any different style, means you can choose here. Clear? So this outline is known as stroke and object's color it is known as fill. Clear? So now we know need of that outline for this activity. So I am choosing the option stroke paint and deactivating the color, that is the option is no paint. Now we have to change this circle into a saucer shape. For that, select the circle. Now after drawing the circle, make it, just transfer from the here the point, make it in the shape of a plate. Can you see that? Yes. The next step it is to, you have to take a copy of this. We are familiar with the word duplicate from Jimb, is it? So right click on the object, you can select the option duplicate. Now you can arrange, you will get another image. Can you see? Okay. Just give the color which is related to the first object and arrange with an option like a saucer. If you need some more clarifications, you have the option gradient. Now you can see in shape of a saucer, is it? So we have two circles in this. These are known as the objects. So just select all the two. If you want to select the two circles, just press the shift key, select one circle and press the shift key and click on another one. It will be selected. And just go to the option group, or here you have object group. So it will be seen as a single object. Clear?
If you have any doubt, you can directly contact me. We'll see you in the next video.